Hi everybody, my name is Sarah Lean and I'm a cloud advocate at Microsoft. In this short video, I want to take you through a new feature within Azure Migrate. That new feature is the ability to take your server inventory data within a spreadsheet and then import it into Azure Migrate server assessment and then get some details out at the other side. So let's delve in. So here you can see we've got the spreadsheet of the server information. We've got the server name, we've got the operating system name, we've got a bunch of utilization data, we've got the disk read write information, you can see the server types. There's tons of information that can be inputted into this spreadsheet. I've just populated some to do this demo. So let's now switch over to the Azure portal and input this details. So we go to the Azure Migrate blade and we click on Assess and Migrate Servers. Now I've already got a project created, so I want to create an additional one to put this input data into. So I click on Change and then click here to create a new project. I'm going to give this project a name and I'm going to put the geography location for the metadata to be stored as well. Next thing I want to do is pick my assessment tool and I'm going to use Azure Migrate Server Assessment, the native tooling within Azure. I'm going to skip adding a migration tool because I don't know which tool I want to use at this point. So I click Add and that's my project created. Now that the project has been created, we can start to discover the servers and this is where we're going to input that spreadsheet. So we change the view to import using CSV and we can see there's a bunch of instructions. It gives us the option to download a template file. Now I've already done that and created my spreadsheet in that correct format. So what I want to do is find my spreadsheet and upload it into Azure Migrate. Now I've sped up this process, it can take a little while, but with the magic of video technology, I've sped it up. So eventually you'll see details around the records that have been inserted, and in this case we've got a failure. Something is wrong with the details that we've put in. So we download that spreadsheet, and if we scroll all the way along to the end, we can actually see the error. We can see that we've missed out some disk utilization inputs. So we're going to go back into the spreadsheet and we're going to change that. We're going to add in the correct disk inputs. So we can see here, I've actually missed disk one read utilization. So I put some stats into that, save it. Now I go back into the Azure portal and I'm going to upload that new spreadsheet. Now again, with the magic of speeding video up, we've sped up the process of inputting that data. And we can see here we've now got 10 records have been found and they're going to be inputted. Now it can take up to 10 minutes for this import to complete, so just be patient on that. Again, I've sped this process up a little so that we can get there quicker. We've now got those 10 discovered servers. So we can drill into that detail and see a bit more about what's happening. If we change the view to import based, we get that information. We get the information from our spreadsheet and it's now visible within Azure Migrate and we can create an assessment for this. Now the assessment helps us build that picture of what happens when we move our workloads into Azure. So we create the discovery source to imported machines and we give the project a name. We've now got a bunch of questions that we want to answer about how we create that assessment. Things like, do we want to use the performance-based assessment? Do we want to use different virtual machine types? There's a whole bunch of information. I'm going to leave a lot of this at default and just change the currency to UK pounds. Now next, we pick the group of machines that we want to create this assessment on. I'm going to pick all 10 machines that was imported. You can see here, I've put a name that's too short for this group. It needs to be at least 4 characters, so I changed that here. And then click Create Assessment. And Azure Migrate will take the imported details, the details from your assessment properties, and create an assessment about what your workload would actually look like if you imported it into Azure based on those scenarios. So now that the report is ready, we can have a look at the assessment data and understand if our servers are Azure ready, the cost involved in moving those servers on a monthly basis as well. We get a quick overview of the Azure readiness of our servers, the monthly cost estimate for compute and storage, and then the storage breakdown. If we delve into the Azure readiness, we can see that 8 of our servers are Azure ready, 1 is ready with conditions, and 1 is not ready at all. So if we dive into this, we can see that VM001 is not ready. And again, if we dive into that detail in a bit more, we can see that one of the disks is not suitable for Azure. And this is where we'd have to go and do our own investigation to understand what's happening with that server and understand why it's not being displayed as Azure ready. Now, if we go back into the report, we can delve into why the other server has been flagged as conditionally supported. Azure Migrate has listed that the operating system is end of support. And if we look at it, we can see that this server is running Windows Server 2003. Now that's a legacy operating system, and to run that on Azure, you'd need to enter into a custom support agreement with Microsoft, or the better way would be to look at upgrading that operating system before moving it to Azure. As you can see, you can get lots of data from this server import assessment. Now the key thing to remember is the data out is only as good as the data in. Thank you for watching.